Good morning, Grade 1. Welcome again to your SSD lesson. We are going to do fun with social studies, and we will be finding changes in pictures on pages 194 and 195. And then we will be doing Unit 4 review on the pages starting from 196 till 200. Let's start. Let's see the objective today: to recognize the changes in daily life brought by new technologies. Okay, students, this is a fun activity now. Now look at both these pictures. Yes, thoroughly look at all the minor details in the pictures as well, because you're going to find many differences here in the picture. Okay, let's look at here what it says here. It says past here and it says present here. So this is something, a picture or something that has happened long ago. And this is what is happening now. Yes, that's what we learned about these two words, past and present. So what is common in these two pictures? The theme of the both pictures is common. You see, they're trying to bake something here. Let's say they're trying to bake cookies. They're trying to bake cookies here, and they're trying to bake cookies in here as well. Now let's spot the differences. What do you think? The first thing, the way people are dressed. Do you see the difference? Look, their clothing is different. The style sense of their clothes is different. This is how people used to wear clothes in the past, and this is how they dress now. Alright, let's look at more differences. So, do you see the stove? There is difference of stove as well. Even the kettle is different. You see it? This is how people used to cook earlier. This is a stove from long ago. This is how we have stoves in our house now. Look here, the clock is different. This is the clock that people used long ago, and now we use digital clocks. Look at the mixer here. Mom is holding some manual mixer that she's going to use with the hand, with the help of her hand. And here it's an electric mixer, an easier way to mix and bake. Look at the phone. Do you see a phone here? I don't see any phone here, a telephone in the past picture. But I do see a telephone here because we use these telephones now. Yes? Look at the milk. This is milk here. We have milk in cartons now. Yes, we get milks in boxes now, but they used to have milk in glass bottles earlier. What else? Can you spot the difference of the cupboard at the back? Look, the change in the design of the cupboard as well. Look at the boy himself and the way he's dressed. There's difference in that as well. I'm seeing a cat here, but I don't spot a cat here. So these both pictures are basically telling you the difference of how people used to bake cookies long ago and how, on the contrary, they bake cookies now. Now let's start with Unit 4 review. Now change. In many ways, people today are the same as people who lived long ago. But the way people live has changed over time. So this is a sequence question now. You can see we have three headings: first, next, and last. These are the two spaces that we have to fill in. For the first one, as a theme, they have already given us in the question. So it says transportation was very slow long ago. Many people did not travel far from home. So what happened next? First, the transportation was very slow. Next, technology helped transportation become safer and faster. And what is last? What happened at last? Technology helped us, and what did we achieve? So today, people can travel around the world in days. Do we all agree with it? Yes. It's so fast to travel now. The transportation is so fast now that within days you can travel around the world. And what helped in making transportation faster? It is technology. Because of the help of technology, today people, humans, are able to travel a lot faster as they in comparison to how they used to travel earlier, long ago. All right? Now, this is a vocabulary question. You will be given some blanks that you have to fill in with the vocabulary words that we have already studied over the unit. So, Zach made dash to show the order in which things have happened in his town. So, what do we use to show the order in which things have happened? You remember chronological order? What do we call it? We call it a timeline. So Zach made timeline to show the order in which things have happened in his town. He learned how people lived in the dash or the time before now. What do we call it? The time before now that has already happened. We call it past. So I'm going to read the sentence again. He learned how people lived in the past or the time before now. He showed how people live now in the present. So the time that is going on now, we call it present. Now, Zach learned how things dash or become different. How things change. We have to write change here. Remember, we learned about change all through the unit. That things change, things become different, people become different. Next, one change is that people now use cars instead of horses. Cars are one kind of dash that makes our lives easier. So it's one kind of technology. Technology helps us make our lives easier. Now on page 197, let's look at this question. Question 6. How was communication changed over time? Can you tell me? How has communication changed over time? So in the past, people wrote letters and talked on the telephone. What do we do today? Now, people still talk on telephone and write emails instead. Do you all agree to this? Yes, we do the same. Now, question 7. How did children get to school long ago? Do you remember we have studied this? How did they travel to the school long ago? They used to walk or they rode in wagons. That's how they used to travel to the school, and it was very difficult for them to reach the school. Now, question 8. What can change a community? Now, people and the kind of work that they do can change a community. You remember we studied this in the lesson about Elkhart, how it's changed and how people have changed over the time. So that's how community changes. Now question 9. Which of these statements was not true long ago? A. People live in communities. B. Games are fun. C. People use email. Or is it D. Children go to school? So which of these statements are not true long ago? So do you think people use email long ago? No. So this is not true. What did people use long ago? They used to write letters to each other. Alright, do you remember? Excellent. Now, question 10. What has made transportation safer and faster? Is it A. communication, B. change, C. tools, or D. technology? What has made transportation safer and faster? It's the technology. It's all because of the help of technology that we are able to make our lives easier. Now on page 198, let's look at these questions. So the first thing you can notice here is we have a table here with two columns. One says past and the other says present, and there are different modes of transportation in both the columns. Alright, so let's look at question 3. Which side of the table shows transportation that we use in the present? So you can look at the pictures on both sides and you can relate which ones look more similar to the transportation that we use today to travel. Do we have cars like this now? or instead do we use cars that are more similar to the picture here in the column for the present? So if you look carefully, all these pictures look more similar to the transportation that we use nowadays. So this side of the table is showing us the transportation that we use in the present. By the present, we mean that we are using now. Now, did people fly in big jets in the past? How can you tell? So we are going to look here. We are going to look for the jets and airplanes. And yeah, I spot one here. So if you look carefully at this plane here, airplane here, do you think it can, it looks big, or it can manage to accommodate many people in it? No, I don't think so. I think only maximum two people can accommodate here in this airplane. So this is not a big jet, and people did not used to fly in big jets in the past because the jet itself looks very small. Now, question number 15. When did people travel on large ships with sails? Yes, when did people travel on large ships with sails? In the past or in the present? Are you seeing any sail here in the picture of the ship in the present? I don't. But if I look at the picture of a ship in the past, I do see sails here. So it means people in the past used to travel on large ships with sails. Now, question number 16. On which side of the table would you add a space shuttle? That's an easy question. Do you think people used to travel in space shuttle to space in the past? I don't. So it means we are going to add the space shuttle here on the right side of the table because we have traveled in the space shuttle to the space in present, and people long ago did not do it. Now let's look at page 199. So what do you see here? You remember we call it a timeline. Now this is a timeline about Mary. What does this timeline show? What does it show? What do you think? Now this timeline shows the things that happened to a girl named Mary. When did Mary get a tricycle? Now let's look at this timeline here. At 3 years old, I spot that Mary gets a tricycle. So when she turned 3, she got a tricycle. Now what happened when Mary was almost 5? So I'm going to look on the timeline after 4 years old, and since it says almost 5, this is probably what happened to her. I'm going to go up and see. It says Mary moves to a new house. So Mary moved to a new house when she was almost 5. Let's look at question number 20 now. What happened last on the timeline? So what is the last event here? It's this one. It's after she turned 6, but before she turned 7. So Mary started the first grade. All right? That's how you read a timeline. One more time, the homework for this week is that you have to finish page 37 on your practice books. I hope you enjoyed today's lesson. I think it was pretty fun. Take care of yourself. Stay safe. Bye.